the young people. The young people at this church, they work so hard.
Amen.
You might see them goofing off and they don't seem like they're doing much, but they are. They studied for the Quizarama. They took their time out of their studies to study. And they accomplished so much, and I am so thankful for them. I'm very proud of them. How they acted, how they were intrigued to learn more about the book of Romans. I asked them, they're not public speakers, so I compromised with them and I asked them to send me at least one sentence, at least, of what they learned from the book of Romans. The book of Romans is a book that Paul writes that helps Christians learn how to live in this dark world. He gives instructions and guidance of how Christians should live. What I'm going to read to you is what your youth wrote from what they got. Some are short, some are longer than others. But I'm so happy and I'm thankful for what they learned. One member said that most of what we learn in the Bible is based off of the major books, whereas Romans has a lot of good analytical content that will help people become more developed in Christ and his teachings through what Paul wrote. Another member said, what I got from Romans is Abraham's faith was so strong, even though everything wasn't in his favor. Another member said, I learned that the Ten Commandments could be summarized into love your neighbor as yourself. Another member said, a church functions properly when its members with different spiritual gifts exercise those gifts in a way that honors God. And lastly, another member said that they learned about the flesh and the spirit. This is what your youth wrote. And as Brother David comes up to give us our time of intercessory prayer, I ask that you meditate on the words that your youth wrote of what they got. Continue to support them and help them grow in their life, in their spiritual lives. Give them little words of wisdom. You might not take it, but at least lend an ear. Speak life into your youth. For they are the church of today and tomorrow. Invest in them. Thank you.
Decisions that they have to make throughout their lives. We pray for this church as a whole,
that we would continue to come together and to meet the mission that you have set for us in this community. We pray that we would be a light, that those that look at our building and our members would see you first before they see us. We pray for our sick and shut-in, those who are at home or suffering from different ailments. We ask that you would continue to heal and bless them as they plead for you, to you for help. Lord, when it's all said and done, we all want to be ready when you come back. Please help us to that end. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.